Hello friends, today I will discuss that tool that I didn't use yet. I noticed in the photo show but never used. As I tried it, I was surprised why I didn't use before. In this video, you will watch a photo show filter that allows object and edits in your image to be scaled and oriented according to the image perspective. Let's watch and know about where we can use this filter. I open a picture of a bedroom on Photoshop workspace. In this picture, I want to add a picture on the back wall on the bedside. So I added a new layer of the picture that I want to add. Normally I use transform tool and use distort or skew option. So you can activate a transform tool by using shortcut Ctrl plus T in the Windows or Command plus T in the Mac. Click the right mouse button and select distort. Transform the picture according to the wall perspective. This tool is a little complicated and not accurate on the all time. I am undoing the same and pasting pictures again by using shortcut Ctrl plus V in the Windows or Command plus V in the Mac. But you need to know that don't copy the picture or any object that you want to paste on the wall. You need to select the pixel of the object by using shortcut Hold plus Ctrl plus click in the Windows or Hold plus Command plus click in the Mac. Then cut the selection by using Ctrl plus X in the Windows or Command plus X in the Mac. Now your selection resides in the Photoshop memory. Create a new blank layer by clicking on plus icon on the layer panel, so you can work in non-destructive way. Now go to the filter menu, then selecting vanishing point. New workspace will open. Select the plane tool and select the wall corner and draw to top end corner. Then keep drawing to the bottom right corner according to the wall perspective and complete the plane to draw on the bottom left corner. Now the wall plane is created. You can see the grids on the plane. Use the shortcut Ctrl plus V in the Windows or Command plus V in the Mac. Picture will be pasted on the vanishing point workspace. Use shortcut Ctrl plus T in the Windows or Command plus T in the Mac to increase or decrease the size. Or you can also select the selection tool. I am reducing the image size and dragging the image into the plane. You can see image will be automatically transformed according to the wall perspective. You have no need to use any other transform option like distort skew as we use in the Photoshop main workspace. This tool is a more accurate and realistic way to place the picture on the wall. After placing the image according to your requirement, click OK to close the vanishing point filter. The picture will be added in the new blank layer, so you can further edit the picture if you need. Your main image will not be affected because you are working on the new layer. To look more realistic, I am opening blending option by clicking twice on the selected layer and adding shadow behind the picture. I am taking a snapshot by using shortcut Ctrl plus Alt plus Shift plus E in the Windows or Command plus Option plus Shift plus E in the Mac. To add more real effect, I am going to the filter menu and selected camera raw. Going to the masking option, selecting a radial mask, drawing the radial on the top part of the picture under the ceiling light, increasing the exposure and it looks like the light fall on the picture. Ceiling lights are falling on the both sides, so I duplicating the radial mask and dragging into the left corner under the ceiling light. This is the final image. Now come to the second option of the vanishing mode. It is a clone stamp. I am opening a new picture of a brick wall. Here is a cloak on the wall. I want to remove the cloak. It is a very easy with the clone stamp or with the content aware tool. So first I am selecting the cloak area and click the right button and select the fill, then select the content aware. Cloak is removed. But bricks are showing uneven according to the perspective of the wall. This method is a not work here, so I am selecting clone stamp and take a sample from the wall by holding Alt in the Windows or Option in the Mac and painting over the cloak. Results are better than the content aware tool, but bricks are overlapping on the other bricks. I am undoing the same and creating a new blank layer. Going to the filter menu, then selecting vanishing point. New workspace will open and I am drawing a plane according to the corners of the wall. I am selected clone stamp from the vanishing point tool option and taking sample from the plane wall and paint over the cloak. You can see the R bricks are in the same line according to the perspective of the wall and bricks. Click OK and changes will be added in the new layer that you have already created. Results are more accurate than normal clone stamp, on the Photoshop workspace. Very minor editing needed here, so I am using again shortcut Ctrl plus T in the Windows or Command plus T in the Mac to transform the new painted layer to look more real. You can also place the text according to the perspective view of the image. I opened a new image and add text in the new document. Make selection of the text layer by hold plus Ctrl plus click in the Windows or hold plus Command plus click in the Mac. Cut the text pixels by using shortcut Ctrl plus X in the Windows or Command plus X in the Mac. Now it's saved in the Photoshop memory. Go to the filter menu and then select the vanishing point. Setting plane by selecting plane tool from the tool panel according to railway platform perspective floor. The corners are not in rectangle, so you need to hold anchor point of the grid by Alt in the Windows or Option in the Mac to extend the plane. You can also create multiple planes and these can be separated or connected. After creating the perspective plane, I am pasting the text by using shortcut Ctrl plus V in the Windows or Command plus V in the Mac. The text will be pasted from the memory of the Photoshop. Transform it by using Ctrl plus T in the Windows or Command plus T in the Mac. Feel free to scale or modify the object. Then once you have satisfied with the shape and size, click on it and drag it inside the plane. You will notice that the object will change shape and size according to its position in the plane. It will get smaller as it gets far away from the camera and bigger as it gets closer to the camera. You can also duplicate the text by holding Alt or Option in the Mac and drag the text to the desired place. Text will be placed according to the distance. I'm duplicating twice, so I have a 3 image of the text. You can see that the text changed shape and size according to its position in the plane. The text I placed far gets smaller as it gets far away from the camera and bigger as it gets closer to the camera. Click OK. All 3 images added in the new blank layer. If you want to delete any, you can erase it from the layer. To make more real, I am opening blending options, selecting bevel light and reducing opacity. After that, I am going to the filter menu and selecting the Gaussian blur. Bring slider to 4.9. It looks more real and blended in the floor. Now I am adding another text to add in a different perspective. Creating text is it and adding some style by using blend if by clicking twice on the text layer. After that, I am selecting rasterizing layer style, open to make it raster image. Make selection of the text layer by hold plus Ctrl plus click in the Windows, hold plus Command plus click in the Mac. Cut the text pixel by using shortcut Ctrl plus X in the Windows or Command plus X in the Mac. Now it's saved in the Photoshop memory. Go to the filter menu, then select the vanishing point. You can see here the old plane that you have created for the stock text. You can also create a separate second plane, just finish working on your first plane. Then click another part of the image and start afresh. I want to have a two plane connected. I need to tear the second plane off from the first. To do this, press the Ctrl in the Windows or Command in Mac and drag one of the edge nodes to create the next plane. So I am dragging one right side node to create the next plane according to the train perspective shape. Both planes are connected now. I am pasting new text by using shortcut Ctrl plus V in the Windows or Command plus V in the Mac. You can resize or transform it according to your requirement and I am dragging it on floor first and it was placed automatically. As I dragging it to new plane according to the train perspective, it was placed automatically. Click OK and new text is added in the new separate layer that we have already created. One thing remember, once you have the object on your clipboard, add a new blank layer above the background image. This is because anything you do inside the vanishing point workspace will be applied to the layer that is selected when you actually open the filter. To make more real, I am making a few adjustments as I did for the stop text. It doesn't affect your background image. In my next picture, you will watch how can we add a window on the difficult perspective wall with clone stamp tool with the help of a vanishing point. You can see this is a very complicated picture. First, I am creating a new layer so we can save the changes on it. Go to the filter menu and then select the vanishing point. I am drawing the plane according to the perspective of the window on the side wall. Take here, draw the plane fit to the same size of the window, otherwise cloning will not be accurate. Now I have connected a new plane for a new wall where I want to clone a window. I need to tear the second plane off from the first. To do this, press the control in the Windows or command in the Mac and drag one of the edge nodes to create the next plane. So I am dragging one edge node to create the next plane according to the new perspective wall. Both planes are connected now. Select and close the tool and set the brush size according to the window and opacity is 100%. Take the sample of the window and moving the cursor on the new wall under the new plane. Window is placed automatically on the wall where I paint according to the wall perspective. Click OK and then I have selected the clone layer that we have already created. I am creating a white mask and paint with a black brush to hide the unwanted area. A minor adjustment needed to place it perfectly. Vanishing point in the Photoshop can make your work easier and faster when you are dealing with the perspective. Hope you will try the same. If you will have any questions, don't forget to ask. I will answer the all questions. That's all for the today. Soon I will come with the new tutorial. Thanks for watching.